स्टार्ट, लेट्स स्टार्ट। ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट शेयर माय स्क्रीन। आई होप यू आर एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन गाइस, राइट? ओके, परफेक्ट। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। ओके, सो टुडेज एजेंडा इज बीए। विल नॉट बी डूइंग आरसी टुडे, विल बी डूइंग बीए वर्बल एबिलिटी। एंड यस, सो जस्ट टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ बैकग्राउंड, Yeah, I have conducted a BA session earlier. I know you have a fair background on BA. Okay, so let me still, you know, if anybody is new in the class, let me tell you, in BA in CAT, as per the last year's pattern, since we don't know the new pattern, we have three types of questions in BA. First is parajumbles, in which you need to arrange the sentences. So you will be given five sentences, you need to arrange it. Then second, parajumbles type 2, which is find the odd one out. Find the odd one out. And third is para summaries or para completion. These two types, remember. So either of the two may appear in your CAT exam. Okay guys, remember that. Okay, so okay guys, so is this clear to everyone? Quick reply on that. Is this clear to everyone so that we can start with the first question for the day? Perfect. Chalo. And I know we have conducted VA sessions before, so I am not getting into the nitty-gritty of it. I am not getting into the, you know, intricacies of it because we have already done these three types. I have, you know, conducted one session on BA earlier, I remember. So I assume that you are aware of the types and you know what is to be done. So let's get into the question and start solving it. Okay, so that's the approach for today. So this is the first question for today. First question for today. So guys, read the instructions and then read the question. Okay. So guys, this is, read the instruction. Huh? logical order of sentences to construct a coherent paragraph. So this is parajumble in which you need to arrange the five sentences in a coherent manner. Okay. So if you remember, I had told you earlier, the first job or the basic approach or the right approach to such questions is to identify the starting sentence. Your first job is to find the starting sentence. So guys, I just want you to read all the five sentences and tell me what do you feel should be the, okay, or which sentence do you feel should be the starting sentence of this sequence. When I say starting sentence, it means introductory sentence. Let's start from there. Can you guys tell me that at least? Read all the five and tell me. Sanket Dofe has already given me the answer. Okay, Sanket, we'll wait for others to answer and then I'll comment on that. Okay. Sanket, we haven't done this question before, na? Right? In the previous VA class that I had conducted. This is a new question, right? Okay, Sanket, thank you. Others, please reply quickly. Which is the introductory sentence? What do you feel? Okay, let me tell you. Sanket is absolutely right. The first sentence in this sequence is sentence B. Good job, Sanket. Keep it up. Now, guys, I'll solve this question. Observe carefully, okay? The first sentence is, well, there was no one on Mars then to watch that event, but it will happen again on November 10th. 2084. Okay. Guys, do you see this? This sentence starts with the word well. There was no one on Mars then. This then, it raises a question in my mind that there has to be some sentence before this which talks about a particular time period. Correct? And that time period has been referred in sentence A using the word then. Then refer to some previous time period. Am I correct? Quick reply on that. Make sense, students? So I know for sure sentence A cannot be my starting sentence. It cannot be my starting sentence, right? Next, there was a time soon after the first landing on the moon in 1969 when we were optimistic. Just a minute, guys. So there was a time soon after the first landing on the moon in 1969 when we were optimistic enough to imagine that we might have reached Mars by the 1990s. So guys, see, such sentences, look at the first part. There was a time soon after the first landing on the moon in 1969. Okay. So these such sentences, they act as a good introductory sentence because it doesn't have a logical antecedent to it. When you read this sentence, you don't get that feeling, okay, there has to be a sentence before this, otherwise this sentence cannot exist. So sentence B can act independently. It doesn't need a precedence to it, okay? So let's move to other three sentences because we cannot conclude at this stage whether B is the starting sentence or not, okay? Next. And I have suggested that on that occasion. Guys, are you able to understand? If my sentence starts in this manner, can I not say that even C is not my starting sentence? Ye padke pata chalta hai na, guys, ki iske pehle aur ek sentence hona chahiye. एंड आई हैव सजेस्टेड दैट ऑन दैट ओकेशन. व्हाट ओकेशन? क्वेश्चन आया ना दिमाग में, व्हाट ओकेशन? वो ओकेशन पता होना चाहिए मुझे. एम आई करेक्ट? नेक्स्ट. इन वन ऑफ माई स्टोरीज, इन वन ऑफ माई स्टोरीज आई डिस्क्राइब द सर्वाइवर ऑफ द फर्स्ट इल फेटेड एक्सपीडिशन टू मार्स, वॉचिंग द अर्थ इन ट्रांजिट अक्रॉस द फेस ऑफ द सन ऑन May 11, 1984. On May 11, 1984, okay. In one of my stories, अभी ये देखो, this is again not my starting sentence. ये पढ़ के पता चल रहा है इसके पहले भी एक sentence होना चाहिए. See, अभी ये जो मैं बार बार बोल रहा हूँ, every time that I'm telling you this, that there should be a logical antecedent to it. This is, you know, basic English. You need to understand this on your own. ये समझ में आना चाहिए कि हाँ, ये पढ़ के पता चल रहा है पहले आएगा कुछ इसके पहले, ठीक है. Next. By that time, I hope that many eyes will be looking for Mars back towards the Earth as it slowly crosses the solar disk, looking like a tiny, perfectly circular sunspot. अभी इधर देखो, कैच क्या है? By that time, question आया दिमाग में? What time? Yes or no? This question crosses your mind, right, students? This what time? That means there has to be another sentence which talks about or mentions about the time which is referred by that in this sentence, sentence C. So I know for sure, after eliminating all the four, that B is my starting sentence for sure. Now remember, in order to find the other four, now I will have to read, get into the sentences and find the links. Okay, let's see. So B, there was a time soon after the first landing on the moon in 1969 when we were optimistic enough to imagine that we might have reached Mars by 1990s. Okay. And next, what do you think should be the next sentence that follows B immediately? No. It cannot be C, Sanket. No, Sanket, C is not correct. Yaksh Dodia is very, very good, very good. Guys, look at the year which is mentioned here. Sentence B talks about 1969. Don't you think so? Sentence D should follow it, 1984? Yes or no? Look at the chronology with respect to years. In one of my stories, I described a survivor, author says here, I described the survivor of the first ill-fated expedition to Mars, watching the earth in transit. Guys, see, expedition to Mars, watching the earth in transit across the face of the sun on May 11, 1984. So D should be my immediately next sentence after B. D should follow B, correct? Now observe carefully, guys, do you remember when we read sentence A, I asked you one thing? Guys, what is this then? There was no one on Mars then to watch that event. Which event? Which event, guys? So now read sentence D, you will get to know what is that event. The event is expedition to Mars, watching the Earth in transit across the face of the sun. Is this clear to everyone? Correct? Do you see this link? Expedition to Mars. Well, there was no one on Mars then to watch. Look at the link. D says expedition to Mars, watching the Earth. Well, A says, well, there was no one on Mars to watch that event. Correct? So BDA is the link. BDA is the link. Is this clear? Now tell me between E and C. E and C. What do you think should be my next sentence after A? Between E and C, what should be my next sentence? Everyone, you should be able to tell me this quickly. BDA, and then next sentence, tell me, guys, should it not be E? Should it not be E, guys? Tell me. By that time, what is that time? Time is November 10, 2084. Am I correct, students? Do you agree with me? By that time, I hope that many eyes will be looking for Mars. See, again, many eyes will be looking for Mars. link is in the in sentence A. Sentence A, it says there was nobody to look at Mars, but E says by 2084, there will be, I hope there will be many eyes looking for Mars, looking from Mars back. Is this clear to everyone? Do you see BDA, right? And C, C is a very good concluding sentence. It is a very good closing sentence. See, just read it once. And I have suggested that on that occasion, the Earthlings should signal to the Martians with powerful lasers so that the latter will see a light beaming the message to them from the very face of the sun. So your final sequence is BDAEC. BDAEC. Is this clear to everyone? No doubts in this? Is this clear to everyone? Okay, moving on to the next question. Okay, guys, chalo, read this. Read this, guys, read this. Similarly, read this and tell me what do you think should be the starting sentence? Okay, Bhushan, so now you are saying sentence C should be the first sentence. Okay? So, Bhushan, you need to understand one thing, correct? See, sentence C says there are many hypotheses. And on the other hand, E says none of these hypotheses. Don't you think so? C and E are directly linked, Bhushan? C and E are directly linked, correct? Bhushan, do you agree with me? But Bhushan, you need to understand, when you say C is the starting sentence, sir, you need to understand, is there any sentence which is a better opening sentence than C? Guys, because Bhushan, if you notice, it talks about it, sentence C is in very detail. It describes many things. But look at sentence D. Look at sentence D. It says art as a whole is not the object of any field of empirical inquiry. Clear, Bhushan? Is this understood?
Yes, sir.
So D acts as a very good starting sentence. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right? So everyone is correct. Tanvi, yes. Yes, good job, Praneet. Yaksh, good job. Starting sentence is D in this case, for sure. Without any, you know, second thoughts. Now the next sentence, okay? Now the next sentence, observe carefully. I'll tell you where to go now. Art is the subject in the entire discussion. Okay. So art as a whole is not the object of any field of empirical inquiry. Next. When the topic is music, it is not visual art. And when it is a visual art, it is not literature. Okay. No, this cannot follow sentence A. Now observe carefully. Okay. I told you that C and E are directly linked. You all agreed with me. C and E are linked. Matlab C ke baad hi E aayega. But isme dekho, aur ek option hai jahan pe hypothesis ka baat hua hai. Yes or no? Wherein it talks about various types of hypothesis. That is, there are serious psychological, anthropological, sociological, and historical hypothesis about all works of art and only works of art. Is this clear to everyone? Correct? Is this clear to everyone? So guys, don't you think so that A should ideally come even before C? A should ideally कम इवन बिफोर सी, बिकॉज लॉजिक देखो ना, फ्लो देखो. यहाँ पे मैं डिस्क्राइब कर रहा हूँ ए में, आई एम सेइंग देर आर थ्री टाइप्स और दीज मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस, साइकोलॉजिकल, एंथ्रोपोलॉजिकल, ये सारे टाइप्स ऑफ हाइपोथेसिस बताया. देन इन सी आई से देर आर मेनी हाइपोथेसिस अबाउट. तो बेसिकली यहाँ पे जो हाइपोथेसिस है, आई एम डिस्क्राइबिंग दैट इन सी. तो सी डिस्क्राइब्स ए, सी डिस्क्राइब्स ए, एंड ई ई सेज दैट आउट ऑफ ऑल दी हाइपोथेसिस, नन ऑफ दीज हाइपोथेसिस आर इवन इम्प्लिसिटली अबाउट ऑल आर्ट. करेक्ट. तो आई नो दैट ए सी इज द लिंक, ए सी इज द लिंक. करेक्ट. तो माई फ्लो इज डी ए सी ई, एंड आई नो आई एम लेफ्ट विथ ओनली द लास्ट सेंटेंस विच इज बी बॉम्बे. सी बी इज अ वेरी गुड कंक्लूडिंग सेंटेंस. लुक एट दिस, इट जनरलाइज एवरीथिंग. वेन द टॉपिक इज म्यूजिक, इट इज नॉट विजुअल आर्ट, एंड वेन इट इज विजुअल आर्ट, इट इज नॉट लिटरेचर. तो यश, आई एम ग्लैड यू गेव मी द एंटायर अरेंजमेंट. यू आर एब्सोल्यूटली राइट, बट जस्ट वन चेंज. ओके, सो बी शुड गो टूवर्ड्स द एंड. डी ए सी बी इज द डी बी बी शुड बी एट द एंड. बी इज द क्लोजिंग सेंटेंस. ओके, लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नाउ. I hope you have understood this. Yes, read this, guys. Read this. Read this sentence carefully. Your first job is to tell me the starting sentence. Just do that. Tell me the starting sentence in this. Guys, you need to keep an eye on all the details, huh? Make sure. You should always keep an eye on if the year is given, you know, then there is a chronology in that. If there are numbers given, you need to keep a track of the numbers. Okay? Go ahead, tell me the starting sentence in this question. Guys, one thing you need to understand, sentences that starts with words like moreover, furthermore, they can never be your starting sentence. Do you agree with me on that? Yes or no? Do you all agree with me on that? मोरोवर मीन्स पहले कोई सेंटेंस होना चाहिए उसके पहले. स्टार्टिंग सेंटेंस मुझे बताओ इस केस में क्या होगा. आई जस्ट नीड दैट. वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड, वेरी हैप्पी विथ ऑल ऑफ यू. यस, ए इज द स्टार्टिंग सेंटेंस, ए इज द स्टार्टिंग सेंटेंस. यस श्रुति, वेरी गुड श्रुति. यक्ष, वेरी गुड. यस भूषण, वेरी गुड. तो ए इज द स्टार्टिंग सेंटेंस. गाइज ऑब्जर्व केयरफुली, आई टोल्ड यू ना मोर ओवर का मतलब क्या है. मोर ओवर इज कंटिन्यूइंग सम आइडिया फ्रॉम अ प्रीवियस सेंटेंस. उसके पहले एक सेंटेंस होना चाहिए, ठीक है, इतना क्लियर है. अब ऑब्जर्व करो ध्यान से, ठीक है. आई टेल यू समथिंग. मेज कैन नॉट बी ग्रोन अबव 12,000 फीट एंड इज रेयरली फाउंड अबव 11,000 फीट. तो सेंटेंस इज मेज Maize is rarely found above 11,000 feet and cannot be grown above 12,000 feet. It means कि maize का जो range है, it is less than or equal to 12,000 feet. Am I correct? Less than or equal to 12,000 feet. Right? Roughly, I can say this. But it introduces maize. It talks about a particular plant or crop. Correct? Maize. Next, moreover, llamas and other camelids are at home at such heights, so the Andes are not quite such an improbable area to be settled. Okay. Next sentence. It was thus the potato that enabled early man to settle in the Andean highlands and escape malaria and other diseases of the rainforest or jungle. Okay. It was thus potato. See, this is a very nice sentence. Okay, it gives me a very fair idea. It was thus the potato. Next, at higher altitudes, only the potato, quinoa, and oca can be grown, but the potato far outweighs the others in importance around Tiwanaku in western Bolivia, where quinoa takes precedence. Chalo, this gives me a very fair idea about my. The moment I read all this, I get to know, okay, what is my answer. ओके गाइस एवरीवन ऑब्जर्व केयरफुली. पहला सेंटेंस मेज का बात कर रहा है कि मेज कौन से हाइट पे ग्रो नहीं कर सकता है. इट कैन नॉट बी ग्रोन अबव 12,000 फीट. डोंट यू थिंक सो गाइस? ए के बाद मैं सीधा डी अगर पढ़ू, डी मेक्स मोर सेंस बिकॉज इट टॉक्स अबाउट हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड. हायर का मतलब क्या है? फर्स्ट सेंटेंस टॉक्स अबाउट लेस देन इक्वल टू 12,000 फीट. हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड मीन्स इट टॉक्स अबाउट मोर देन 12,000 फीट. एम आई करेक्ट? यस और नो? लुक एट द कनेक्शन बिटवीन द टू सेंटेंसेस गाइस. ए सेज मेज कैन नॉट बी ग्रोन अबव 12,000, वेर एज डी सेज नहीं, दैट्स नॉट करेक्ट. एट हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड ओनली द पोटेटो, क्विनोआ एंड ओका कैन बी ग्रोन, राइट? सो एडी इज द लिंक. एडी इज द लिंक. एंड यश, वेरी गुड, फर्स्ट टू सेंटेंसेस एकदम करेक्ट है तुम्हारा, वेरी नाइस. ओके अब इसके बाद देखो, एट हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड्स के बाद ओनली द पोटैटो, क्विनोआ एंड ओका का बात हुआ है. यहाँ पे तीन की बात हुई है. तो डोंट यू थिंक सो द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस दैट शुड इमीडिएटली फॉलो दिस शुड बी अबाउट पोटैटो और आइदर ऑफ द थ्री. तो वी हैव अ सेंटेंस सी सी. इट वॉज दस द पोटैटो दैट एनेबल्ड अर्ली मैन टू सेटल इन द एंडियन आईलैंड. येस और नो गाइस? टेल मी येस और नो एवरी वन. एम आई करेक्ट? तो एडीसी एडीसी इज क्लियर, वेरी क्लियर ऑन दिस, राइट? नो कंफ्यूजन. नेक्स्ट लेट्स रीड सी. इट वॉज दस द पोटैटो दैट एनेबल्ड अर्ली मैन टू सेटल इन द एंडियन हाईलैंड्स एंड एस्केप मलेरिया एंड अदर डिसीजेस ऑफ द रेन फॉरेस्ट और जंगल. नाउ सी द लिंक इज एंडियन हाईलैंड. डू यू फाइंड एनी अदर सेंटेंस गाइज? टेल मी, लुक लुक अराउंड एंड टेल मी दैट टॉक्स अबाउट द हाईलैंड्स. डू यू फाइंड एनी अदर सेंटेंस दैट शुड फॉलो सी? वेरी नाइस. सी दीज हाईलैंड, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड दीज हाईलैंड? टेल मी गाइज. इट इज एंडियन हाईलैंड. वेरी नाइस भूषण, वेरी नाइस. ई एंड द लास्ट सेंटेंस इज बी. सो द करेक्ट सीक्वेंस इज ए डी सी ई बी. यश, डिड यू गेट योर मिस्टेक? यश, आई होप यश यू हैव अंडरस्टूड योर मिस्टेक, राइट? वेयर डिड यू गो रॉन्ग? सो दीज हाईलैंड. हाँ, थैंक यू यश, वेरी गुड. दीज हाईलैंड वो कैच था, इसमें याद रखना. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन गाइज, दिस इज रीड द इंस्ट्रक्शन. दिस इज टाइप टू ऑफ बी ए. आइडेंटिफाई द ऑड वन आउट. दिस इज ऑड वन आउट. आउट ऑफ द फाइव सेंटेंसेज आई वॉन्टेड टू रीड एंड टेल मी विच इज दैट सेंटेंस दैट यू नो दैट इज नॉट इन सिंक विद द अदर फोर. आउट ऑफ कॉन्टेक्स्ट कौन सा सेंटेंस है, पढ़ के मुझे बताओ. चलो ट्राई दिस गाइस. रीड केयरफुली गाइज, रीड केयरफुली, डोंट बी इन अ हरी, टेक योर टाइम, थिंक नाइसली, जस्टिफाई ईच एंड एवरी सेंटेंस इन योर माइंड एंड देन टेल मी विच इज द ऑड वन सेंटेंस. ओके, ऑड वन आउट सेंटेंस. सो यू शुड कीप एन आई ऑन, यू नो आई मीन द फ्लो ऑफ द सेंटेंसेज. ओके एंड प्लीज डोंट अप्लाई दिस लॉजिक. टॉरेंशियल डाउनपोर, torrential downpour, torrential downpour, torrential downpour, torrential downpour. Please don't do this. This is a flop logic. It doesn't work in CAT. See, if you notice, all the five sentences have, you know, torrential downpour. This, the keyword is there in all the five sentences. So it is not going to help you in any manner, okay? Rather, read it and understand what is the context. ओके प्रथमेश सेज ही फील्स सर सेंटेंस टू शुड बी द ऑड वन आउट. व्हाई प्रथमेश, इफ आई मे आस्क यू, व्हाई कैन यू एक्सप्लेन मी व्हाई? Why do you feel two is the right answer? Two is the odd one out?
Sir, actually, in all the other sentences, it shows the current filling of the torrential downpour. Whereas in question two, it is telling me that we should describe the atmosphere prior to it.
Okay.
So that was the
logic behind you saying two, right? Okay, yes. Prathamesh, listen to me carefully. So while I am explaining it to you, others will also learn and understand ki kya ho raha hai isme. Theek hai Prathamesh? Observe Prathamesh. First sentence is, peering through the torrential downpour, I could just make out the hunched over silhouette of my wife, pedaling as hard as she could, but seemingly going nowhere. Okay, right? So just keep this on hold. We'll come back to this sentence later, Prathamesh, okay, after reading the other four, right? Now, in the second sentence, the author says, many northern states are deprived of the torrential downpour. Prathamesh, what is the meaning of the word deprived? Any idea?
Deprived means not getting the availability or something.
Very like nice, very nice. Kisi cheez ka kami hona is deprived, theek hai? Right? So let's say if we don't have basic facilities in health and infrastructure, we say that we are deprived of good healthcare system, right? In our country, waisa bolte na? So very good. So many northern states do not experience. Our deprived ka matlab kya hai? Northern states mein torrential downpour nahi hota hai. There is no torrential downpour in northern states. And for me to explain its splendor, I must first describe the atmosphere prior to it. Okay. Next. The torrential downpour is one experience which does not require acuity to fascinate us. Okay. I pity those who have not bathed in the torrential downpours of the southern states, for such a shower cannot be found in the most elaborate of spas. And last says, I have encountered much that is mystical, but the torrential downpour will forever amaze me. Okay. Prathamesh, are you listening to me?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Prathamesh, abhi odd one out kaise dhoondte dhyan se dekhna. Mistake kya hua hai tera, main bata raha hu. Did you notice, Prathamesh, that in these four sentences, all the four sentences, 2, 3, 4, 5, it talks about torrential downpour in some or the other way. Yes or no, tell me.
Yes.
But look at the first sentence. In the first sentence, the entire focus of the discussion is not on torrential downpour. See, it says peering through the torrential downpour. And look at this part. He talks about a new context. Correct? Pedaling as hard as she could. Okay, so the author is talking about his wife. Yes or no?
Yes.
Makes sense? Main kya bol raha hu?
Yes.
Baki charo sentences, the other four, it talks about torrential downpour in some or the other way. But the first sentence, the entire focus is on the experience of the author's wife. And he says, I could just make out the hunch over my wife, pedaling as hard as she could, but seemingly going nowhere. Is this clear?
Yes.
So answer is option one. Odd one out is option one. Thank you, Prathamesh. Everyone in the class, have you understood it? Tell me. You must have read it by now and you must have got a basic idea of the question kya bol raha hai, correct? That is why one is the odd one out. Remember, guys. For odd one out, I always recommend, please read all the five sentences. Without reading, you cannot guess. Similarly, this is again an odd one out question. Try, guys. Try this, guys. Hello, everyone. So guys, what do you think is the odd one out in this case? Anybody? Yash says 2, Prathamesh says 5. Any other answer? Okay, guys, observe carefully, okay? Any other answer? Anybody else? Do you have a different answer? Question says 4. No. So 5, 2, and 4 are not correct. Guys, answer is 3 in this case. The odd one out is 3. I'll tell you something why, okay? Guys, confronting a slowing economy, Chinese leaders must say to populace that has come to expect an ever-rising standard of living. Okay, now observe carefully. They must contend with public calls to clean up the environment and pay more than lip service to the rule of law. I want everybody to text me and say, who are these people? Who are they? They kaun hai mujhe batao? They kaun hai idhar? Everyone in the chat box, quickly. Very nice. Chinese leaders, very nice, everyone. Aarti, very good, Aarti. Shruti, very good. Either bhi dekho, they must combat endemic corruption in the ruling Communist Party. Manage China's worsening relations with its neighbor. Dekho, either bhi, they Chinese leaders hai. Dikh raha hai sabko. Are you able to get the sling, guys? Correct? Either bhi Chinese leaders hai. Am I correct? Next. Now, look at the first sentence. Now, add the specter of ethnic unrest. Simmering for years to Beijing's daunting to-do list. Okay? Now, this is again. This sentence 1 follows 5. 5 padhne ke baad aapko pata chalega 1 follows. Correct? They must combat endemic corruption in the ruling Communist Party and manage. So this sentence 5 says, Chinese leaders need to combat. Combat means fight back. So ye do cheez karna hai, ye do cheez to karna hi hai. Aur ye kya bol rahe? Now add. So there is one more thing which is being added to the responsibility of the Chinese leaders. Correct? But why 3 is the answer, I'll tell you guys. Observe carefully. Sentence 3 says, despite being officially included as citizens and members of the Chinese nation, ethnic minorities, ye dono minorities ka naam hai, kya likha hai? Think that their nations. Guys, quick reply on this. Don't you think so? This is opinion of the minorities or the ethnic groups. Quick reply on this. Is it not the opinion of the ethnic group? Makes sense? So now tell me, is it about the Chinese leader? Is it about the Chinese leader in any manner? No, it is not. It is rather about the opinion of the ethnic groups. And that is why 3 is the odd one out. Baki 4 sentence, Chinese leader ke baare mein baat ho rahi. But only sentence 3 talks about the opinion of the ethnic group. I hope this is clear. I hope
sir,
this is clear. Bolo.
Sir, I have a doubt. Why not 5? Means if the 1, 2, 3, 4 are dealing with the internal parts of China, means like...
No, 3 is not dealing anything about internal parts of China. Did you read this, Prathamesh? ये क्या सोचते हैं ethnic group they are independent and not part of China ना बेटा अब समझा ये वाला part
but it is and it is currently in the part of China right
नहीं I know it is currently part of China look here ना that is what sentence C says despite being included as citizens and members of Chinese nation what about the people ना जो रहते हैं वो कौन ethnic minorities है right प्रथमेश ये सारे What is their opinion? What do they think that we are not part of China? It is like Kashmiris. Kashmir ke logo kya lagta hai? We are not part of India. Hai ki nahi? So ye to unka opinion hai na? Kya unke manne se aisa ho sakta hai ki India ke bahar ho tum? Nahi na? It is still a part of India. Kashmir aaj bhi apna hai, right? So that is why sentence 3 is odd one out because it is giving you. It talks about the opinion of the ethnic groups. So, for that matter, apna example lunga, opinion of the Kashmiris. Is this clear?
Yes.
Sentence 5, tu dekhega, to it talks about Chinese leaders. 4 bhi Chinese leader pe baat kar rahe. And first and second to kar hi rahe definitely. Is this clear? Understood? So, odd one out aisa dhoondna hota hai, Prathamesh. You need to look at the sentence that talks about a different idea or altogether a new idea. Understood? Is this clear? Okay. So odd one out again. Try this, guys. Ye wala try karo. Go ahead, read it. This is a very easy question. You should be able to crack this, guys. Karo sab. Oh, am I audible, students? Can you hear me? There was some network issue at my end. Okay, perfect. Yeah. Sorry for the disturbance. Continue, guys. Continue. Guys, keep an eye on the numbers. Take care of, you know, understand which sentence talks about a new idea or a different idea. odd one out is very scoring. So guys, what is the answer? Tell me. Which sentence do you think is the odd one out? Guys, what is the answer, everyone? Okay, Prathamesh says 5. Okay. Prathamesh, your thought process is absolutely right, but you're not able to understand one thing that, you know, see, I mean, when you say 5, Prathamesh, you need to understand Wall Street traders lost their heads on Wednesday, October 23rd. You need to understand, is it related to some other sentence? If it is, then this cannot be your answer. And if you look at the 4 sentences, they all talk about the stock market only. Everyone, what is the answer, guys? Yaksh says 1. Okay, good job, Yaksh. Very nice. Yaksh, why 1? Can you just unmute yourself and share with us? Why 1?
So in the first sentence, it's a generalized statement regarding to the crash of stock market. And in others, everything detail is given.
Very nice. Very nice. Yaksh, good job. Absolutely correct. Answer is 1. Very nice, Yaksh. Keep it up. So guys, as he rightly said, if you look at the other 4 sentences, the 2, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th, they all communicate the same idea. It is talking about a common topic, which is the stock market crash of 1921 and the side effects of it. So I'm pretty sure you must be aware of the Great Depression of 1929, Great Economic Depression. It is mentioned in the PPT also, I mean the question, the Great Depression. And if you look at sentence 2, 4 and 5, it talks about the consequences of the stock market crash of 1929. Yes or no? Can I get a quick reply on that, everyone? Yes or no? Makes sense? But if you look at question, sentence 1, why it is your answer? Why this is the odd one out? Read it. Let's read it. You will understand. In the days leading up to crash, the market was severely unstable with periods of selling and high volumes interspersed with brief periods of rising prices and recovery. So guys, sentence 3 talks about the stock market crash. 2, 4 and 5 talks about immediate effects, immediate side effects of the depression, great economic, the market crash basically, correct? And then 1, if you notice 1, It's a very general statement. It's a very general statement, yes or no? And also it doesn't talk about the immediate effects. It says in the days leading up to the crash, in the days leading up to the crash. And that is why it is the odd one out. Is this clear to everyone? Have you understood now? Can we move to the next question? Okay. Okay, third type of question. I told you we'll be doing all types of VA today, VA questions. Four alternative summaries are given. Choose the option that best captures the essence of the text. Guys, this is para summary. So read the passage. I want to read this and tell me which is out of the four options, which is that option that covers the entire passage. The para summary, remember, the answer should summarize the entire passage. Matlab main ye bolna cha raha hu, if there is an option which covers only one aspect of the passage, then it is not your answer. Any option that covers everything of the passage, everything that is given, overall idea of the passage, then that is your answer, okay? Go ahead, I want to see, you know, how you think. Go ahead and tell me your answer. Just a minute, someone has entered into the club. Go ahead, read the passage and let me know what do you feel, which option summarizes the entire passage in the best possible manner. Okay, Bhushan says C. Okay, Bhushan, let others finish. Yash says Yash D. Yash says D. Any okay? I've got three answers. Prathamesh says A. What about others? I want girls to reply now. Only the boys are active today. Girls, come on, show some energy. Shruti Kamble, yeah. Thank you for pitching in. Shruti, yes, okay. Shruti says D. Okay. Guys, remember, para summaries are the easiest, I'm telling you. Easiest. Very, very scoring. just you know think wisely, observe, analyze the options very well. People who have given me answer as C and A, Bhushan and Prathamesh. I want you to just compare C and D because other people have given answer as D. Okay, I have not commented anything on the final answer, but just see, is option D a better answer than C? If yes, then remember, C must have not covered something or at least one part of the passage or one thing about the passage. And that is why people are saying that D is a better answer. So Bhushan and Pratham is just analyze. Okay, guys, so time up. Guys, remember one thing. First of all, answer is option D. So Yaksh, Yash and Shruti Kamble, very good. Keep it up, all three of you. And Bhushan and Prathamesh, let me explain you what went wrong. Okay, let's understand the passage first. The paragraph says, mechanical devices tend to be self-explaining. Their moving parts are visible, can be watched or manipulated. They make natural sounds that help us understand what is happening, so that even when we are not watching the machinery, we often infer their state just from these sounds. So guys, it is about the, you know, any device. So I can think of an example of mechanical watches. Okay, so any mechanical device, the phenomena of this device is to make sounds. बहुत आवाज होता है ये device, mechanical जो device होते हैं बहुत आवाज करते हैं, they make a lot of sounds. ठीक है, so that is what the author is saying. Mechanical devices tend to be self-explaining because their moving parts are visible and can be watched or manipulated, and also they make natural sounds. Correct. So the author says even if we are not looking at the machinery, we can still understand the situation, condition of that machine, of that device, just by hearing the sounds. Okay. Then the author says today, the author says that today the scenario has changed. Now the author says that it is not like before. Today these mechanical devices, okay, they are hidden from sight and sound. Taken over by silent, invisible electronics. So as a result, many devices operate silently, efficiently, and aside from the occasional clicking of a hard drive or the noise of a fan. Then it says they do not reveal much of their internal operations. We are left without much information about the device's internal workings. What is happening within the device? So guys, now you must have noticed, you know, there were so many devices, you know, old device makes sound. And what is the beauty of the new device, new era's device? Tell me. They don't make sound, yes or no? Absolutely silent. Correct? Now let us read the options. Mechanical devices are self-explanatory. Yes, this is given in the passage. See, self-explanatory. But less efficient. While electronic devices are more efficient but harder to understand. This option is absolutely wrong. This option is absolutely wrong. Why, guys? Less efficient or more efficient? This is like data not given. Can I get a quick reply on this? Do you agree with me on this? Data is not given, guys. No. Comparison of mechanical devices and electronic devices, although it is done, but we don't have data in the paragraph, which is more effective. Right? So one is gone. Second, mechanical devices which are efficient but noisy. Yeah, this is given. See, it is efficient but noisy, correct? No, again, the same problem. Efficient, this word is wrong. So second option is also gone. Mechanical devices are noisy. This is true. Have nowadays been replaced by electronic devices. This is also true. That are silent. Then same problem. Less efficient. Efficient. We don't know. Data not given. Right, students? And then moving to three. In the past, we had mechanical devices that were self-explanatory. This is true. But now they have been replaced by electronic devices whose internal workings remain a complete mystery. This is also true. Correct. This is also true. Because see, we are left without much information. This indicates workings within a complete mystery. We don't have much idea about the internal workings of the mechanical device. Next, electronic device. Next. Mechanical devices are easy to understand because their parts are visible and they make sounds. Guys, tell me one thing. This is given in the passage, not directly. This covers first part of the passage. Yes or no, everyone? This covers first part of the passage. And second, see, as opposed to electronic devices, it compares the mechanical with the electronic device, whose internal workings are invisible and mostly silent. So that is why D is my better answer than C. Okay, better answer than C. And I'll tell you something. Why C is wrong? Another reason. Observe. Guys, what is the meaning of the word a complete mystery? Complete means what? Complete means what, guys? No idea at all, na? Am I correct? Complete means zero idea. Kuch pata nahi uske bare mein. No information at all. No information at all, right? But guys, passage kya bol raha hai? We are left without much information. So guys, what is the grammar kya bolta hai? What is the meaning of the word much? Much means not many, but a few. Am I correct? Not many, but a few. Am I correct? तो विदाउट मच इन्फॉर्मेशन का मतलब क्या है? ऐसा नहीं कि मुझे कुछ आइडिया नहीं है. इट्स नॉट दैट आई डोंट हैव कंप्लीट आइडिया, बट द अमाउंट ऑफ आइडिया दैट आई हैव और इन्फॉर्मेशन आई हैव इज नॉट वेरी ग्रेट. इट्स वेरी लेस. नाउ डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड पीपल हु गिव आंसर एज सी? डिड यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई सी इज रॉन्ग?
यस सर.
परफेक्ट. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. Guys, now try this. Try this one. Para summary again. Try this. Read carefully, guys. Okay, so just keep an eye on extreme word. When you have very strong words in an option, remember, usually those options are not the answer. So example is the complete mystery, the one that I explained to you in the previous question. Keep an eye for such words. Strong words will never be your answer. Guys, what is the answer? Tell me. What do you think is the answer? Guys, go with the elimination approach. Huh? Very nice. Yes, yes, bahut sahi abhi jawab diya. Good job. Eliminate karo, guys. Eliminate. Don't run behind finding the right answer. Always eliminate. Elimination is very important. Yes, very good. Answer is D. The term non-standard has no meaning in a language until one dialect of a language becomes the standard. Very good. This was a very easy question, guys. I mean, easy to moderate, doable question. So guys, see, this the first option is wrong because it doesn't cover the entire passage. There's no justification for calling. Because variety reflects diversity of language. See, no justification and reflecting society's diverse structure and differing practice. Only one part of the passage it covers. It doesn't cover the entire passage. Then second says it is incorrect to call any kind of language usage non-standard, as the standard language is nothing more than a special dialect of that language. No, this is not correct. It is not that it is standard language is more than a special dialect of that language. Correct? The passage says exactly the opposite. It says only when one dialect achieves a special social position, okay, then it becomes a standard. Is this clear? Is this clear to everyone? So if you read sentence C now, until we can decide which variety of language is it standard dialect, it makes no sense talking about non-standard. This is wrong. This is wrong. Now look at D. The term non-standard has no meaning in a language until one dialect of a language becomes a standard. This is exactly what I'm talking about. So makes sense, guys. Is this clear to everyone? Why D? Okay, next question. Okay, read this, guys. Read this.
Guys, the main crux of the passage is if we are, if counting thousands, if counting a number which is in thousands or the number of pebbles in the jar, okay, or the sweets in the jar, when it is in thousands, the author says, if it is becoming so difficult for you to count, when the total number is in the range of thousands, some thousand, what will happen to you? If it is in million, 10 million or 100 million. This is what the entire crux of the passage is. So what should be the answer, tell me? I have told you, na, strong words. Strong words should, options should be immediately eliminated. Can anyone tell me which are those two options? Impossible. It's a strong word, yes or no? Reply quickly, guys. When I say impossible, that means I am generalizing something. I am fixing it. Kab kab possible hi nahi hai, but passage ye nahi bol raha hai. Then we cannot hold. This is also not true. We find it hard to imagine. Correct. Aisa likh sakta hu main. It is difficult for us. That is also true. Now tell me which should be the answer. What do you feel? Should it be A or should it be D? First or fourth? Yes, Prathamesh, it is A. Very good, Prathamesh. Yes. Yes, Bhushan. Yes, yes. Yes, guys, so it is A. Because we wrongly guess, it is not correct. Right, yes, Prathamesh, am I correct? Okay. Now this is to construct a coherent paragraph. Guys, try this. This is parajumble arrangement. Arrangement question. You have to arrange the five question sentences. So guys, tell me, what do you think should be the first sentence in this arrangement? Started hundo khali pehle. First, tell me the first sentence. And it is very clearly given. The first sentence is given very clearly. Everybody, I'm sure all of you will get it right. Yes, Praneet Ramteke. Very good, Praneet. Continental drift is now a fact. Look at the introductory sentence. It is so beautifully and clearly given over there. Prathamesh, yes, I know you were saying B, no problem. It is so clearly given. B is the starting sentence. Now look for internal links. Now try and find the internal links. See, continental drift is now a fact. Now you need to find a sentence that talks about this drift, the continental drift. And if that is not, then see which is the other sentence that I can start with. After B, continental drift is now a fact, right? What is the meaning of the word drift? Guys, what is the meaning of the word drift? Drift is movement. Drift is movement, correct? And guys, see, plate tectonics. This question talks about the movement of plates in the earth's core. Tectonic plates that we have. You understand my point? Wo jyada move karta hai, toh earthquake aata hai. Do you all know this or not? Tell me. So guys, I'm saying continental drift is now a fact. And the next sentence should be E. Read E carefully. Gap between European and North America is ever widening. Growing at the speed of a human fingernail. Guys, continental drift ho raha hai. Isiliye gap bad raha hai na, dono ke beech mein. Very nice. Yash ne to pura series hi de diya mujhe. Yes, very good. You're absolutely right. It is BDCA. Good job, Yash. Full sent. Pura. You answered the entire question. Very nice. Ab guys, mujhe baaki log ye batao. Continental drift is now a fact. If continental drift is happening, iska matlab kya hai? Gap between Europe and North America bad raha hai. Am I correct? Yes or no? Tell me. Correct? And then word dekho, this has been established, proved beyond doubt by the almost impossibly precise measuring devices carried by satellites in orbit. This has been established. What is this? This kya hai? This kya hai? Batao mujhe. Jo E mein baat hua hai, gap ka. This has been established. Matlab wo gap badh raha hai, has increased or has widened between Europe and North America. It is confirmed. Confirmed by satellites in orbit. Satellite se picture leke confirm kiya hai. Ki haan, gap badh chuka hai Europe and North America ke beech mein. So BED ho gaya. Abhi next dekho C hoga. The means by which this happens. Ab dekho this again fir se iska baat ho raha hai. Gap ki baat ho raha hai. The means by which this happens. The hypothesis of plate tectonics is though still just a hypothesis. And last A, dekho, it is a very good concluding sentence. But ye sara jo four mein char sentences mein baat hua hai, usko contrast kar diya. BEDCA. But it is a hugely successful hypothesis, one that accommodates pretty well in every geological observation currently being made, be it to do with volcanoes, earthquakes, or the distribution of today's animal and plant communities. ये देखो क्लोजिंग सेंटेंस है ये. एम आई राइट? मेक सेंस एवरीवन? हैव यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड गर्ल्स एंड बॉयज? ओके परफेक्ट. सो मूविंग अहेड, सो वी विल कम टू दिस लेटर. लीव इट फॉर नाउ, टू मच टू रीड. I know you must be tired now. Let's take a. ठीक है, try this. Try this. Find the starting sentence. That's very important. The journey starts there. Find the starting sentence. No, Praneet. Please read the instruction. Guys, read the instruction once. Praneet, sentence 1 and sentence 6 are already arranged. Sentence 1 and 6 are already arranged. वो सही है. ये बीच के चार को अरेंज करना है, मैं बोल रहा हूँ. नो नो प्रॉब्लम प्रणीत, पढ़ो वापस, ट्राई करो. Sentence 1 is absolutely correct. D 6 is also correct. अभी 1 पढ़ के कौन सा फॉलो करेगा मुझे बताओ. 1 के बाद इमीडिएटली व्हाट डू यू फील द नेक्स्ट सेंटेंस दैट शुड फॉलो. the origin of modern science lie in period of rapid scientific development that occurred in Europe between, which we now refer to as the scientific revolution. Yes, Bhushan Sonawane. Very good. Bhushan has given me a very good answer. Perfect, Bhushan. Next sentence that follows one immediately is D. Yes. Guys, even if you leave, you read, you understand. See, you know, of course, scientific investigations were pursued in ancient and medieval times. Two, the scientific revolution did not come from nowhere. D, after one D should come here. And what is this final sequence? Very good. Prathamesh Shinde, very good. DCAB. Yes, Tanvi, you are right. Tanvi, you are right. You all are right. Very good, very good. Guys, can we move to the next question if you have understood? Can we move to the next question if you have understood? All of you are correct. Very good. Chalo. Okay, wait, I want you to try this now. Try this. See, why did I skip that question, you know? First sentence one, first and last sentence are given, and then remaining middle sentences you need to arrange. So that is, that is a very old pattern of CAT. So CAT has stopped asking you parajumbles in that manner in the last 5-6 years. So we took one or two examples just to get a feeler of it, that how is it. In case if it appears this year, you should not be in a moment of surprise. Okay. So let's focus on this one. This is important. This is definitely going to be there into this year's CAT. Odd one out again, odd one out. You are a science student, JTI, na? Yes. You will love this question. Ideal solution A and B. Chalo, padho aur mujhe batao. I want everybody to get this right. Which is the odd one out in this? Bata do mujhe. This question is very simple, guys. You should get it right. And this is your area, science. Quickly. Word hai usme, catch hai. Ek catch hai, guys. Sub sentence check karo dhyan se aap. Aapko aa jayega. No, Tanvi, no. 4 is not correct, Tanvi. अभी मैं बताऊ तन्वी, यू विल बी सरप्राइज टू नो कि सर वो शर्ट कैसे मिस कर गई मैं. तन्वी ध्यान से देखना भी. मिक्सिंग ऑफ गैसेस. तन्वी बाकी सेंटेंसेस लिक्विड का बात कर रहा है. मिक्सिंग ऑफ लिक्विड्स का बात कर रहा है. ओ यस, हुआ ना तन्वी. डिड आई नॉट टेल यू मोमेंट ऑफ ट्रूथ है ये. वो लगता है ना, ओ शिट हाउ कुड आई मिस इट. मैंने बोला बार बार, कीप एन आई ऑन द वर्ड्स. ध्यान दो है ना गाइस. हाथ का मार्क्स था ना ये तन्वी, राइट? चलो, आई एम ग्लैड यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. नो प्रॉब्लम. आगे से ध्यान दो गाइस. सबको समझ आया ऑड वन आउट वन क्यों है? इट इज द ओनली सेंटेंस दैट टॉक्स अबाउट मिक्सिंग ऑफ गैसेस. कैन वी मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स? Thank you. sir. Let's move to the next question. Yeah, odd one out. Try this. Carefully, guys. Read the sentences carefully. Very nice, very nice. Yash and Prathamesh, very good. Good job, guys. I am very happy today. Very nice. Good job. Yes, odd one out is option sentence two. Odd one out is sentence two, yes. Good teachers learn to multitask, attending to students' individual activities as well as managing the larger group. Yash or Prathamesh, can any one of you unmute and tell me the reason? Your thought process, why two is the odd one out? Maine answer de diya, you are right.
Sir, in all the options, they are telling that government teachers are obligated to do that particular work. Whereas
very nice.
In second, it is clearly indicating that what teachers, basically the ideal teacher does.
They learn to multitask. What is, very nice. Good job. Prathamesh or Yash, kaun tha?
Prathamesh.
Very good, Prathamesh. Keep it up. So, others, I hope you have heard what just Prathamesh explained to me. So understand carefully, okay? So, baki sab mein dikh raha hai, you know, in other sentences, it is clear that the freedom of the teacher is hampered. There is no freedom for the teachers, right? They have to follow the rules or the patterns set by the government. Okay, so top down efforts tell teacher do it this way. Iska matlab kya hai? So guys, when we tell someone that you have to do it this way only, it means you are forcing that person to not do the work the way he or she wants. Okay, so freedom is hampered. In sentence B, sentence two, it talks about qualities of a good teacher, right? It talks about qualities of a good teacher. That is why two is the odd one out. Chalo, can we move to the next question, guys? And that would be the last question for today, and then we'll stop. Can we move to the next question? Okay, this is the last question for today, for the day. Tell me, odd one out again. Which is the odd one out? So we have practiced all the three types of questions today: para jumble arrangements, odd one out, and para summaries. I want Tanvi to answer this question. Tanvi, this is similar to mixing of gases, huh? Tanvi, मुझे बता कौन सा ऑप्शन है और कौन सा वर्ड है जिससे पता चल रहा है कि आंसर क्या है. ठीक है Tanvi, understood मैं क्या बोल रहा हूँ? Is this clear?
Okay.
Tanvi, very good. I am very proud of you. Last question for the day, mast kiya tune. Bata de mujhe Tanvi, can you unmute yourself and explain us? Yes, one is the right answer. Very good, Tanvi.
Yes,
what's
sir.
The catch? Explain me.
Sir, in the statements other than one, it is said that the uniform is basically like decided by high ranking individuals. But for statement one, it is said that in an army gone increasingly high tech, the modern military uniform is less than outfit than a system. मतलब कुछ like उसमें वो लोग tech like मतलब मुझे समझाओ, समझाने नहीं हो रहा
है. I got it. मेरे को समझ गया. तू absolutely right है. तेरे को भी समझा ना, तुझे समझा. तू कहना क्या चाह रही है मैं बता रहा हूँ Tanvi. You are trying to say कि sir यहाँ पे एक्चुअली ड्रेसेस का यूनिफॉर्म का डेकोरम का बात हो रहा है, राइट? कि ड्रेस कोड क्या है, सब जगह बात हो रहा है, करेक्ट? बट यहाँ पे जस्ट बिकॉज आर्मी हैज गॉन इंक्रीजिंगली हाईटेक, दे हैव मेंशन दैट द यूनिफॉर्म इज नो मोर देन अ, यू नो, इज नो मोर अ यूनिफॉर्म, करेक्ट? इट इज लेस एन आउटफिट देन अ सिस्टम. समझ आ रहा है क्या? सो दैट्स अ डिफरेंट आइडिया. ये ऑल टुगेदर नया आइडिया यहाँ पे इंट्रोड्यूस हो रहा है, इसीलिए इट्स नॉट वन आउट. Very good, Tanvi. जाते जाते correct answer. Very nice. Thank you for that. Okay, guys. So that's all for today. I hope you got a fair idea. And we practiced all the three types today. We practiced all the three types: parajumbles, arrangements, then odd one out, and then para summary. So I hope you got a fair idea, okay, how to go about each of these type of questions. I'll see you on next weekend, okay? And till then, take care, keep studying. In case of any doubts, please approach me, okay? Take care, everyone. Enjoy your Sunday. Have a good day, guys. Bye. Take care. Yes, welcome everyone. Your pleasure is all mine. Bye, guys. Take care. Bye, Tanvi. Bye. Bye, guys. Bye. Bye.